So the trick for doing algorithms like value iteration in an infinite state space, like what you get from the belief MDP, is going to come only by looking really, really, really carefully at the infinite case and then showing that we can re-represent it in a finite way. So what we're going to do now is actually step through what value iteration would look like in POMDPs, and then piece by piece, we're going to convert that to something that actually can be computed. So at first, it's going to be math, and then it's going to be an algorithm. So here's value iteration written out. And it's in POMDPs, but sort of doesn't really matter yet. We're going to define the value function at step zero to be, as a function of the belief, to just be zero everywhere. And then we'll say for t greater than zero, the value function for time step t as a function of the belief state b is going to be the max over all actions, the reward for taking that action in the context of that belief state, plus the discounted expected value of where we end up, right? So what we're going to observe is an observation z, and so let's sum over all the possible observations, the probability that we make that observation times the value function at the previous time step for the resulting belief state b prime, which is what we get by doing what we talked about on the previous slide, which we'll call the state estimation for B, A, Z.
All right. That seems reasonable.
Yeah.
I mean, other than the fact that R is not a function of B and A, that just means the reward you actually got.
Right. So let's, what is this like? What is the reward for being a belief state B, given that we take action A? How can we re-represent that in terms of quantities that we're more familiar with?
By unrolling probabilities or something the same way we did last time?
Yeah, and in particular, all we have to do is say, well, we would get the reward for state S if we were in state S. So let's just sum over all states, the probability that we're actually in that state, the reward that we would get from that state. And of course, this is just the belief state for state S. So this is really just the dot product of the belief state with kind of a vector that you could make out of the rewards for a given action.
So it really is just the average reward you would expect given the belief state.
Exactly.
Okay.
And so again, now that we've got that out of the way, the scary thing here is this function V, this value function, is defined over an infinite set of belief states, these vectors of probabilities over states. So again, we're not going to let that scare us quite yet. But it is something that we have to keep in mind. Otherwise, we could just implement this directly. All we would need is a loop that would say, for all belief states, do this update. It's just that there's an infinite number of them, so that would not terminate.
Yeah, but you could write it in really just a few lines of code.
Yes, you could write an infinite loop in very few lines of code.
It's beautiful, really.
This is how we're going to jump from the infinite to the finite, to the finite, is we're going to make a claim. And the claim goes like this, that for all t, the value function at time steps t over all belief states b, over the infinite set of possible belief states, can be written in a finite way. In particular, the maximum over some set of vectors, gamma sub t, that we're going to have to deal with later, but the point is that it's a finite set of vectors, the maximum of the dot product of the vectors in that set with the belief state.
Okay.
Where dot product is really just the sum over all the states, the weighted probability being in that state times this alpha of S. So this kind of function is sometimes called piecewise linear and convex. And the reason is that if we think about belief space as being, well, let's just do a really simple one, like the space of probability distributions over just the two possible states. So we have some probability between 0 and 1, and if we are probability 1 represents we're totally definitely in state S1, otherwise if the probability 0 we're totally definitely in state S0, and in between we're in between, there's some probability of S0, some probability of S1, in halfway in between would be half of each. Okay, so what functions of this kind have in common is that each of these alpha times b is a linear function of the belief state. All right, so each of the alphas in this set capital gamma sub t is some linear function of the belief state. And what we're going to do is we have a whole bunch of them. At any given belief state B, what we're doing is we're taking the maximum value of all these possible linear functions. So at the end of the day, the actual function that we've represented is this upper surface of these linear functions, each of which is defined in this set, capital gamma. Does that make some sense?
Sure. It makes me think of something we did in the last class.
What was that?
Well, when we did the game theory stuff. Remember that?
Yeah, so, right. So maximums over linear functions comes up in game theory as well. Yeah, it's a good point.
And they end up looking very piecewise linear.
Yep, and convex, right? This is sort of open upwards to the top. And that's because of the max, and the piecewise linear is because it's a finite set of linear functions.